फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल जूलॉजी क्लब। दिस इज आवर न्यू चैप्टर मेडिसिनल एंड वेटरिनरी जूलॉजी। सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज ब्रीफ अकाउंट ऑफ द लाइफ हिस्ट्री, मोड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन एंड पैथोजेनेसिटी ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पैथोजेंस विद रेफरेंस टू द प्रोफाइलैक्सिस एंड ट्रीटमेंट। सो आवर पैथोजेन इज उचेरेरिया बैनक्रॉफ्टी। लेट्स स्टार्ट। Our first question of this topic is some characters of Uchereria bancrofti. This is the picture of Uchereria bancrofti. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Some characters of Uchereria bancrofti. Uchereria bancrofti causes bancroftian filariasis elephantiasis. Habitat: the adult worm lives in the lymph nodes and lymphatic vessels of human only. Morphology: adult worm are long, hair like transparent and filiform thread like in shape. Adult worms live 10 to 15 years or more. Males and females usually remain coiled together. Male: it measures 2.5 to 4 cm in length, then 0.1 mm in thickness. The tail end is curved ventrally and possesses two spicules of unequal length. Female: the female worm measures 8 to 10 cm into 0.2 to 3 mm. The tail end is narrow and pointed. The female lay actively motile embryos and are ovoviviparous. Embryo, that means microfilaria. Passing through lymph nodes, the actively motile embryos find their way into circulatory blood. The larvae retain eggshell. Hyaline sheath, it is the envelope of the egg. The larva can move within the sheath. Size: it measures about 275 to 300 into 8 to 10 micrometer. Somatic cells: these cells are distributed along the axis of the microfilaria and are called as somatic cells or nuclei. Genital cells: the cells are situated anterior to the anal pore. Central body of Manson: it extends from the anterior body to the genital cell and represents rudimentary elementary canal. If these microfilaria are not sucked up by mosquito, they will die in course of the lifespan of the microfilaria could be up to 70 days. Our second question of this topic is life cycle of Uchereria bancrofti. Life cycle of Uchereria bancrofti complete its life cycle into two hosts. The definitive host is man, and vector, that is female mosquito, is intermediate host. The major vector in India and most other parts of Asia is Culex fatigens. Aedes anophilus species of mosquito also serves as intermediate host. Definitive host: in man, adult worm live in the lymphatic vessels and glands. Female lay microfilaria which travel ultimately to bloodstream without undergoing any developmental changes. Nocturnal periodicity: the microfilaria of Uchereria bancrofti takes rest in the capillaries of lungs, hearts, kidney and the big arteries during daytime and invade peripheral circulation at night when man biting mosquito are more active, that is nocturnal periodicity. Intermediate host: the sheathed microfilaria is ingested by mosquito during its blood meal. They casto their sheath in the stomach within 15 to 30 minutes, penetrate the stomach wall within 1 hour, or two and migrate to the thoracic muscle, where they molt and undergo development to first, second and third stage, that is phylary stage, from larvae. The motile third stage larva is infected form. When microfilaria does not multiply in mosquito, the infective larva is injected into man by mosquito during its blood meal and the life cycle is repeated. Larval development in the mosquito takes about 11 to 14 days. Infection of man. When the infected queueless mosquito bites a man, the phylary form larvae are injected into the bloodstream. The larva reaches the lymphatic vessels and lymph nodes of the body. The larva reaches the lymphatic vessels and lymph nodes of the body. They develop into adult with 5 to 18 months. The period from entry of larvae to development to adult forms in human is called biological incubation period or pre-patent period, which is about 8 to 12 months. Then a new generation of microfilaria is emitted, which passes either through the thoracic duct or the right lymphatic duct to the venous system and pulmonary capillaries and then to the peripheral circulation, thus completing the cycle. Our third question is, describe the morphology of larval stage of Eucheraria bancrofti with illustration. Let's start. Embryo, microfilaria. Passing through lymph nodes, the actively motile embryo find their way into circulatory blood. The larvae retain eggshell. Hyaline sheath, it is the envelope of the egg. The larva can move within the sheath. Size, it measures 275 to 300 into 8 to 10 micrometer. Somatic cells. These cells are distributed along the axis of the microfilaria and are called somatic cells or nuclei. Genital cells. These cells are situated anterior to the anal pore. Central body of Manson. It extends from the anterior body to the genital cell and represents rudimentary elementary canal. This is the picture of stages in development of juveniles in mosquito. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Generally, female adult lay microfilaria, that is embryo, which travel without any development. Microfilaria generally takes rest in the internal organs at daytime and become more active at night when blood-sucking mosquitoes are more active. The sheathed microfilaria is ingested by mosquito during its blood meal. They, that is microfilaria, cast off their sheath in their stomach within 15 to 30 minutes. Then within 1 to 2 hours penetrate the stomach wall, then they molt and undergoes first, second and third larvae. This third stage larvae is infected. Our fourth question of this topic is, what is elephantiasis? Name the vector intermediate host causing elephantiasis. Write down the development of the parasite inside the intermediate host of the causal organism. This is a very important topic. The name of the vector causing elephantiasis, mainly female mosquitoes such as Culex fatigans, is the main vector, but Aedes or Anopheles species of mosquitoes also serve as intermediate host. Elephantiasis, the affected part becomes enormously enlarged, producing a tumor-like solidity. This is the end result of uchererial infection and usually follows years of continuous infection. It is not the inevitable termination of every filarial infection. Cause of elephantiasis. Fibric construction of the afferent lymphatics draining the part. Such a pathological change is brought about by recurrent attacks of lymphangitis over many years. Hypertrophy and hyperplasia seen in elephantiasis are the result of excessive protein in the limb exudate, stimulating the connective tissue to excessive growth. Elephantiasis of legs result from obstruction of inguinal or iliac lymph nodes, whereas elephantiasis of scrotum results from obstruction of superficial inguinal lymph nodes. Pathological anatomy. The surface of the skin become rough, fissured and even papillomatous. The hair become rough. On section, the skin cuts like an unripe pear. It is thickened and dense. Blood microfilaria. These are generally absent either due to the death of adult worms or their filature or their failure to reach the systematic circulation due to lymphatic obstruction. The development of the parasite inside the intermediate host of the causal organism. Mainly in human body, the microfilaria of Wuchereria bancrofti takes rest in the capillaries of lung, hearts, kidneys and the big arteries. During daytime, the microfilaria invade peripheral circulation at night when man-biting mosquitoes are more active. Thus, the life cycle is repeated. Larval development in mosquito takes about 11 to 14 days. Our fifth question of this chapter is, add a notes of the pathogenicity by pathogenic reaction. The pathogenic effects seen in Wuchereria are produced by the adult Wuchereria living or dead. Living microfilaria circulating in the blood are not known to produce any pathogenic effects except in occult filariasis. The injurious influence excited by the adult worm and developing larva on its host is an inflammatory reaction of the lymphatic system. Lesion in occult filariasis is caused by microfilaria and is found not only in the lymph nodes but also in lung, liver and spleen. The metabolites of the growing larvae is highly reactive individuals may give rise to allergic manifestations such as urticaria, fagitive swelling, the lymphoedema, etc. These symptoms may appear much earlier within a few months after the exposure. Examination of the peripheral blood fails to demonstrate any microfilaria at this stage, but biopsy of a regional lymph nodes may show the presence of mature and immature adult Wuchereria. Causes of lymphangitis. Mechanical irritation caused by the movement of the adult parasites inside the lymphatic system. Liberation of metabolites of the growing larvae in highly reactive individuals and secretion of the same toxic fluid by fertilized females at the time of parturition. Absorption of toxic products liberated from dead worms undergoing disintegration. Causes of lymphatic obstruction. The following are the various factors which cause an obstruction to the lymph flow. First, mechanical blocking of the lumen by dead worms, that is single or a branch, which act as an embolus. Obliterative endolymphangitis. Endothelial proliferation and inflammatory thickening of the walls of lymphatic vessels. Excessive fibrosis of the lymphatic vessels caused by recurrent and repeated attacks of lymphangitis, fibrosis of afferent lymph nodes draining a particular area. Effects of lymphatic obstruction. Two types of conditions are produced. First is lymph varix and second is elephantiasis. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Here, the first figure is males and females of Wuchereria bancrofti lymph node. Second, lymphoedema or lymph variasis. Third figure is obliterative endolymphangitis. Fourth figure is the occlusion of a lymph vessel. Fifth figure is a parasitic onion developing around a degenerated parasite. Or the last figure is formation of a hyaline scar. Our sixth question is, state briefly the mode of infection of Eucheraria bancrofti. Mode of infection, inoculative method through the bite of mosquito. Transmitting agent, female mosquito, that is Aedes anopheles culex. In India and China, Culex pipiens fatigans. In Pacific Iceland, in Melanesian Iceland, except Fiji and New Caledonia, Anopheles punctatus, and Polynesian Islands, Aedes polynesis. Infective form, third stage larva of developing Eucheraria bancrofti. Portal of skin, portal of entry is skin. Site of location, lymphatic system of superior or inferior extremities according to the site of bite, most commonly of the inguinoscrotal region. Biological incubation period, that is pre-patent period, this lasts about 1 to 1.5 years. During this period, third stage infective larvae grow to adult forms which become sexually mature. Mating subsequently occurs, the fertilized females begin to parturient female and the microphyllaria appear in the peripheral blood. This is our seventh question of this topic, prophylaxis and treatment of Eucheraria bancrofti. This is our last question of this topic. Let's start. The best way to prevent lymphatic filariasis is to avoid mosquito bites. The mosquitoes that carry the microscopic worms usually bite between the hours of dusk and dawn. At night, sleep in an air-conditioned room or sleep under a mosquito net between dusk and dawn. Wear long sleeves and trousers and use mosquito repellent on exposed skin. Another approach to prevention includes giving entire communities medicine that kills the microscopic worms and controlling mosquitoes. Annual mass treatment reduces the level of microfilaria in the blood and thus diminishes transmission of infection. This is the basis of the global program to eliminate lymphatic filariasis. Experts consider that lymphatic filariasis, a neglected tropical disease that is NTD, can be eliminated globally, and a global campaign to eliminate lymphatic filariasis as a public health problem is underway. The elimination strategy is based on annual treatment of whole communities with combinations of drugs that kill the microfilaria. As a result of the generous contributions of these drugs by the companies that make them, hundreds of millions of people are being treated each year. Since these drugs also reduce levels of infection with intestinal worms, benefits of treatment extend beyond lymphatic filariasis. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and like this video and share this video with your friends. Thank you.